our history, the history that we learn, that we teach ourselves, the history that our own historians, with the perspective of the Africans, have now revisited, and to teach our children, and we go back to education, it is important to educate, but also what is it exactly that we are educating our children with? A mother, I am a mother and I can say it, when we have to feed our children, we are very wary about what we're gonna give them. We want them to be healthy, we don't want them to eat things that are toxic. However, when it comes to mind toxicity, we're not so selective. We trust that other people will make decisions to teach us what we're supposed to know. However, in the curriculum, unfortunately, all across Africa, and I've seen it, and also in the diaspora, there is not enough element to tell us who we really were and who we can become, because there is no way we can forge a strong African identity. And I'm talking about identity because I'm a clinical psychologist as well, a mental health counselor, and there is no way we can build a strong identity if we don't know where we come from, if we are not proud of who we have always been, and that is for 300,000 years, because it's very easy to say that Africa is the cradle of civilization, or the cradle of humankind, but it's not just the cradle, it's the castle as well, because we've been around here for 300,000 years and almost sapiens sapiens. So that tells us something about our ancestors and their know-how about how to interact with each other, how to have civil society, how to have good viable economic system, how to have good education system, how to also interact with nature in a way that we don't destroy our environment. So we have a great body of knowledge, a great body of wisdom that should be part of the education system, so that when we build the foundation for the future of the African people and all the ones, of course, who love Africa, because it doesn't have to be just with Africa, but we build it on solid ground. We build it on the foundation of our forefathers, so that we can now have some kind of interaction among each other to know what kind of endogenous type of philosophy or development we want. We cannot develop ourselves in outside of our culture. We cannot develop ourselves copying somebody else's culture, because the fact of the matter, other people's culture have evolved and they've adapted to it and they have made sound decisions about the reason why they want certain things. So we have not. We have been catapulted into a different paradigm, and it's important that we create our own. And so therefore, I'm actually inviting people to go back to those chiefs, to go back to their ancestors, to go back to their grandfathers, their grandmother, and say, hey, talk to me about your life. How was your life? How did you deal with this issue? Why would you do this? Because there is a body of wisdom that surpassed even our understanding, and surpassed the understanding of a lot of the people that came and told us that we were not capable. So if now we're learning quantum physics and quantum mathematics, and we're realizing that the laws of physics are not the same in all different realm of reality. And yet again, our forefathers knew that. They didn't call it quantum physics, they didn't call it quantum mathematics, but yet again, they knew the principles. So I encourage people, when we talk about education, to never forget to go back and see, because other people do it. Why are we still studying the Romans? Why are we studying the Napoleon Wars? Why are we studying the history of England? And why are we not studying the history of Kim Pavita, of Queen Zinda, just to name a few queens? But we have to also bring forward a different type of education, because what we put in our mind cannot be toxic. Because if we have toxicity in our mind, we will produce a toxic result as well. Thank you.
No, thank you. So this whole idea, big round of applause for Royal Annis.